Welcome to another podcast of A Better You with your host, A.D. Fullwood, conference speaker, mentor, and ordained minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, changing your perspective on how you can see the better you living within. Welcome. Thank you again for tuning in to another podcast of A Better You with your host, Apostle Andre Fullwood. I'm just glad to be with you today. Amen. To go on further with who I am in Christ and the subtitle, Because of What He Has Done, where this is part four, I am redeemed. Do you not know that you've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb, you know, which is Jesus Christ? Hallelujah. And I'm just glad to be able to share. I thank all of you who have replayed this podcast. It does my heart good, and I still ask that you share. Amen. If I'm saying something that has touched you, saying something that has inspired you, please tell others, amen, about what A Better You podcast is all about. Some call it a motivational speaking with a Christian base, a Christ-centered, amen, and that's how I see it. That's how, you know, I feel my calling is to encourage, uplift, amen, and not tear down. Glory to God, and just share, you know, what the Lord has shared on my heart. And I'm a teacher, so you ain't gonna get no hooping and hollering, my hand behind my ear, and you know, and all that other crazy stuff. Glory to God, amen. So this one is I Am Redeemed. Now, the last podcast, you know, just reflecting back a little bit, talked about I am rescued. And the scriptures were Matthew 20 and 28 and 1 Timothy 2, 5 through 6. And the 3 points that were made was that I have been rescued from a life-threatening situation. 2, Jesus paid the ransom for my life with his own life. And 3, sin no longer holds my life hostage. Amen. Amen. So you can always go back when you go to Spreaker. That's Spreaker.com. And you search me, Andre Fullwood. You go to the podcast, you'll be able to see every podcast that I've done. Amen. And, you know, being new, you know, into the Spreaker, you know, format family. I want to thank all those that do listen, you know, via Spreaker. And also those through Facebook, also those through Twitter, LinkedIn, YouTube. I just say thank you from the bottom of my heart. Amen. So get your Bibles. It's time to open up that Word of God. Amen. The first scripture we're coming to is Ephesians chapter 1, verses 13 through 14. Amen. And it says, in whom ye also trusted, after that ye heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, in whom also after that ye believed, you were sealed with that Holy Spirit of promise. Verse 14, which is the earnest of your inheritance until the redemption of the purchased possession unto the praise of his glory. Amen. Amen. Don't you know Jesus paid the price for you? Amen. You didn't ask for it. Glory to God. You didn't deserve it. And you didn't know anything about it. Amen. But Jesus did this over 2,000 years ago. Amen. And even in John chapter 17, you know, Jesus prayed that all would be saved. Amen. Prayed that all would be saved. And you and I should be doing the same thing. We should be praying that every human being, every soul, shall be saved. Amen. And you're going to have some that's going to deny. You're going to have some that's going to reject Christ. Don't take it personal, but still pray for them, because somebody prayed for you. Believe it or not, somebody prayed for you. Amen. And even when you went through the hardest times of your life and you think that God was not there, God was there. Amen. God was there. And so we see here that the Holy Spirit is our promise until he comes back to get us. The Holy Spirit is the promise from God that has sealed us. So when it's time for us to be caught up in the air with him, glory to God, when it's time for us to go home with the Lord, we're already marked. It's already sealed, and the promise is there. So every day we walk this earth, and we walk with kingdom authority. Amen. Amen. God has given us territory for us to reign and rule. Amen. Just like it's so in heaven. And we got to exercise that. Amen. That's a whole different lesson right there. Amen. But we got to exercise that. Amen. And so I'm going to give you pointer number one, is that I have had my life debt covered and my future holds an inheritance with God. I'm going to say it again. I have had my life debt covered and my future holds an inheritance with God. My future is with God. I have an inheritance. My inheritance is being with the Father. Amen. You know, many of us, and some of you are going to be upset about what I'm about to say is, you know, and I see it on Facebook, you know, all the time, rest in peace, rest in heaven, you know, mama, daddy, sister, brother. Yes, we miss those. I'm not insensitive to that. Glory to God, I'm not insensitive to that and none whatsoever. But we're living this life to live again with God. We will die, you know, unless Jesus comes back before that. But for the most of us, we're not going to see Jesus return. So how is your relationship with him? That's going to bring you to God. Is your name written in the Lamb's Book of Life? It don't matter how much you prophesy. It don't matter how people fall out and you get all excited like the anointing's all on you. You know, no matter how you preach and entertain the people and hoop and holler, all that stuff means nothing if you don't have a relationship with the Father. You may say, well, what do you mean? As church people, those that if you hear me and you're born again and Jesus is your Lord and Savior, if you can do all those things and yet still do ungodliness behind the eyesight of man, but God still sees, and as you proclaim to have a relationship with God in the midst of the people, do you have a relationship with God, a true relationship with God, when the people are not around? That's what God's looking at. Even as you're up there preaching, God knows he's not even mine. He's speaking my word. He's preaching. He has a gift. You know, gifts and callings come without repentance. But he does wickedness. And he's no part of me. And yet, that individual don't even know that. Because honestly and truly, and I'm kind of drifting a little bit, I'm going to pull back. Do you truly believe the word of God? Many of us truly don't believe the word of God. Because you know why? You know why I say that? Because we keep doing some of the things we're doing that we know we shouldn't do and have no fear. We have no fear of punishment. We have no fear of death. We have no fear of God, that his word is true. Amen. Galatians lists a lot of things that if you possess, you should not enter the kingdom of heaven. My God. All right. We're going to go on to Colossians. Amen. Amen. We're going to go to Colossians. It's going to be the first chapter. Amen. It's going to be verse number 14. Amen. Get your Bibles. Pull out your phone. Amen. Colossians chapter 1. Verse 14. And it says, now remember now, I am redeemed. You are redeemed. In whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sin. you know, I probably said this before, but I'm going to say it again. You've been redeemed through the bloodshed of Christ Jesus. And can't nobody take that away. I don't care how people look at you. I don't care about people's opinions about you. You know, you got to have a, especially being in the body of Christ, you got to have some thick skin. You got to have some tough skin, like some alligator skin. Amen. Because there's going to be some things in amongst your brothers and sisters that they're going to say and they're going to do that's going to come up against you. Glory to God. And you're going to say in your mind, I thought they were saved. We all had that thought. You know, it'll process real quick through your mindset. Glory to God. It'll process real fast. You know, or you may be shocked by certain behaviors. But what we all have to understand is that all of us are human. And all of us, and I'm not saying that as a mistake. And I'm not going to go anywhere. God knows my heart. Yeah, the Bible says the heart is evil too. So then you have that. But we have to understand that everybody's progression in God is different. Everybody's application of the word of God and how effective it is in their lives is different. You can tell by the spiritual maturity from month to month, year to year. Amen. Where is the elevation? Many people don't want to embrace the elevation because they don't want to let go. Here's a nugget here. They don't want to let go of their past. My God, here's something for you. I'm ringing the bell. I'm ringing the bell. Many of us do not want to embrace the elevation in God to go higher in Him, to become more mature in Him, to have our minds more like Christ because we don't want to let go from whence we came. There's just some things that we just believe we can still do. We've lied to ourselves. We fooled ourselves into believing that we can still do these things. That is ludicrous. That is so ludicrous. And so when you see people at the same place over and over again, plus, you know, we do have religious churchgoers. They just go every Sunday because that's what they've been brought up to do. But yet, the abundant life is not living in them. Amen. Point number two. Of I am redeemed. My life is no longer a worthless debt to sin. My life is no longer a worthless debt to sin. Do you not know that you're valuable to God? Do you not know? You know, I know a lot of times in church we say, oh, I'm not worthy. Evidently, God saw fit that you was worthy because he sent his son to die. And as I said in the previous broadcast, he died for all, but only many received him. Thank God you're in the many. Thank God that before the foundations of the earth, that God had preordained you at some point in time in your life to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, that the angels in heaven rejoice. Amen. And now you have full access to the Father. You are heirs with him. You are joint heirs with Jesus Christ. So you may feel unworthy, but I thank God that he saw the whole entire humanity worthy of his son dying so he can have a people that he can call his home, peculiar people, amen, that loves him without having them act like robots. You know, he gave us the free will to choose him. And I think that's what's so awesome about God. People choose God or they don't choose God. And then those that don't choose God, they get mad because God hasn't done this for them, for their lives, or God allowed a loved one to die or something like that. But if you accepted God, and if you truly come into relationship with God, you would understand that even in the midst of death, God is still there. My God, that God is still there. Amen. Hallelujah. So it's the blood. You know, now the lay is saying is that the blood still works. You know, the blood worked, period. The blood worked. Why do I say that? Because it redeemed us and it brought us back into right fellowship with the Father. You know, the other podcast, I said that we were enemies with God. We weren't a friend of God. Amen. like Abraham, we were not a friend of God. We was an enemy of God. And who are we that can stand before the Almighty God? There was a play out, my arms are too short to box with God. We can't box with God. Try fighting God, I guarantee you, you'll lose. All the money in Vegas, God will win. Amen. He will win. Glory to God. We're going to go to Titus. Amen. Amen. You know, some may say, you know, why are you teaching this? And because we don't understand who we are in Christ. You know, the way we walk, the way we talk, the way we behave. You are royalty. You are a royal region in the earth. You're supposed to be a mirror image of God. Oh my God. You're supposed to be a mirror image of God on the earth. I got to ring the bell on that one. I'm going to ring it one more time for those that missed it. Amen. You are a royal region in the earth. Why did Jesus, whatever you bind in earth should be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose in heaven should be loose in earth? He's giving you authority to use your mouth to speak and declare. What thus says the Lord? Oh my God, y'all not getting me today. Y'all not getting me. I'm getting happy up in here. You're not getting this. Many of the circumstances that are happening in your life, you can redirect it or change it or bring some things to pass if you open up your mouth. Open up your mouth and stop being afraid. And that's the thing with the devil. The devil don't want us to praise God. The devil don't want us to pray. You know, the devil don't want us to spend time with God, to build a relationship with God, because he still wants to have a foothold on your soul so that eventually he can pull you away from God or have you lukewarm, where the Bible says that he'll spit you out of his mouth because you have no purpose. My God. Some of y'all might want to hoot on that one. I can't do that. All right. Titus chapter 2, verse 14. Titus chapter 2, verse 14. It says, who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from all iniquity, and purify unto himself a peculiar people, zealous of good works. He gave himself for us. So when we talk about love, and I mentioned this in the last podcast, when we talk about love, who do you know would go through the heinous debacle of torture for you? Have you ever seen a crown of thorns? Have you ever seen how long the thorn is on the crown? And how those thorns were pressed into his head? And what amazes me, thank you, Holy Spirit, is that throughout all his torture, and it started at the Garden of Gethsemane, because even when his sweat turned into blood, you got to remember Jesus hadn't ate since the Passover. He did not have another meal. Oh my God. He did not have another meal on earth. That's a Selah moment. That's a Selah. I'm sorry. That's a Selah moment. Right there. His blood turned into... His sweat turned into blood. My God. So he was already weak and he was already becoming dehydrated. And yet he still had to go through more for you. He had to go through more for me. He had to go through more for your children. He had to go through more for your husband. He had to go through more for your parents. He went through more for the whole entire race. My God. Jesus wasn't racist. He came to save them which were lost. But how dare we pick and choose who we witness the gospel to, as if they're not worthy of hearing it. If you were worthy of hearing the gospel, so are they. And just because you feel that you arrive and someone else you look down upon, because they probably had some hardships. How dare you? How dare you look down on someone who still has a drinking problem? How dare you look down on someone who has a sexuality problem? How dare you look down on someone who has a gossiping problem? They need prayer. They don't even know it, but you need to begin to intercede for them so that they can come up to a level of maturity and healing and deliverance from the blood of the Lamb, Jesus Christ, just like you have. How dare you? Judgmental people. Amen. We should be guarding our hearts daily, making sure that we're not being judgmental toward anyone. Look in the mirror. That's the biggest enemy you have right there is yourself. Hallelujah. Point number three. I now look forward to rich meaning and purpose in God's future plan for me. I'm going to repeat it. I now look forward to rich meaning and purpose in God's plan for me. Amen. Don't you not look forward to the things that God... Many of us don't even know our purpose in God. Why God created us. What is your purpose? What is your assignment here on earth? Do you know? It's real simple formula. Whatever really hits a nerve in your heart that you like to change, that you speak out for or against, that is your purpose. That's your purpose. Amen. My purpose is doing what I'm doing right now. Amen. I'm tired because I've been hurt in the church. You know, shared stuff with pastors that was supposed to be confidential, but was used as pulpit sermons. Glory to God. You know, these type of things. I've seen people, you know, share stuff with the pastors, and the pastors took what they said and used it over the pulpit. You know, these small churches and where the pastors feel like, well, if you don't like it, you can leave type mentality. These are the type of pastors I'm talking about. Yeah, I'm calling you out. I'm not saying no names, but it's not just those that I've been in connection with, but it's all over. You know, we have these, you know, pastors who start out, you know, loving, you know, and caring, and then their hearts change and it shifts and it looks like it's all about them instead of the sheep. And so now everything is focused on taking care of the shepherd, but who's taking care of the sheep? My God. Ding ding, the bell is rung. Who's taking care of the sheep? If the pastor's always trying to move up in their lifestyle and trying to do, get a job. That's what I'm going to tell you to do. Get a job. You got pastors with small, I don't even know why I'm going this way. It must be the Holy Spirit. I don't know why, but you got pastors that have small congregations, but they want to live in the finest neighborhoods. Get a job. Get a job. Put the people in bondage over finances and things of that nature. It's time out for all that. And if you, as a believer in Christ, you need to open up your eyes, glory to God, and wake up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 9. Hebrews chapter 9, verses 12. Hebrews chapter 9, verse 12. Almost done. Almost done. Neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by his own blood he entered in once into the holy place, having obtained eternal redemption for us. If you go back and study the Old Testament, you know, they went for the animal that was spotless, you know, took the blood, you know, put it on the mercy seat, did all these things, and it only covered for a year. Amen. Every year they did this. But glory be to God. The perfect Lamb went into the holies of holies one time. My God. for the rest of our days. He never had to deal with it again. He didn't have to come back the following year. Glory to God. His blood satisfied the Father for your total redemption. His blood, not goats, not calves, but Jesus' blood. And he said he entered in once, he entered in once into the holy place, having obtained eternal, lifelong redemption for you and for me. You've been redeemed. Let the redeemer of the Lord say so. Hallelujah. You've been redeemed. Glory to God. Put some praise up in here. You've been redeemed by the Father, by Jesus Christ, who sent his Son here. Amen. That's something to shout about right there. All right. Amen. I hope that you go back through these scriptures. Amen. And I am totally open for any type of feedback, glory to God. We're going to 1 Peter chapter 1. Amen. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 18. Glory to God. Who am in Christ? Because of what he has done, I am redeemed. You know, there's nothing you did on your own. It was through the pure grace of God. Amen. He wanted a family to call his own who would willingly, amen, accept him as Lord and King of their lives. And I mean Lord in every area. And yes, you know, don't ever think that I'm portraying myself like I'm perfect, because Lord knows, I know, I ain't that I'm not. And there's things that I know that Andre personally needs to work on. And I go to I talk to the Father about them and all this stuff. You know, it's better. You know, it's one thing if you feel you need to lie to someone. But why lie to the Father? You might as well just come clean with him, because he already knows anyway. And I believe the more humble you are when you come before God and acknowledge who you are, you know, from time to time, you know, when you look in the mirror, ask God, how do you see me through your eyes? Listen and be still. You may be surprised at what he tells you. You know, we can't get all caught up thinking that we're all that, you know, in a bag of chips before the eyesight of God. You know, we're made of human flesh. We probably live more in sin than we lived in God. So there's some proclivities. You know, there's some habitual habits that we still have that we need God to pull out by the root. Amen. We don't need to burn it. We need to pull it out. Amen. When you burn it, it still might be something left in this flesh. No, I need you to pull it out completely. I don't need to see not one sign of residue left in me. Amen. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 18. For as much as ye know that ye were not redeemed with corruptible things. Now, you know, we just read that we've been redeemed by the blood. As silver and gold. Those things are corruptible. Amen. Corruptible. From your vain conversation received by tradition from your fathers. Verse 19. But with the precious blood of Christ, as of a lamb without blemish and without spot, who verily were foreordained before the foundation of the world, but was manifest in these last times for you. My God, plain and simple, Jesus paid the price. He paid the price for your redemption. He paid the price to rebuild the bridge that was broken back in the day of Adam and Eve. Jesus paid the price for you and for me. Now, I rejoice over that. And there's times that we allow the complexities of our daily lives to consume us so much that we don't tell God thank you. You know, we don't give him a hand clap of praise. But right now, I just think it's just, you know, if you haven't taken the time, if you're hearing this podcast, to give God some praise, we can do it right now. You can tell God thank you, that God, you love me. you know, that your son who became flesh on this earth died for us and was obedient all the way into the cross, died, risen on the third day with all power, glory to God, all power in his hands. Amen. And don't you know that you are joint heir to all that power? You know, Proverbs 18:21, life and death is in the power of the tongue. You know, and do you not know that if you speak death, you eventually eat death? My God, you speak life, you'll be able to enjoy the blessings of life. Amen. He said, I came, you know, that you might live a life more abundantly. Amen. Satan has his purpose to steal, kill, and destroy. Amen. But Jesus came that we might have life and have it more abundantly. That's what he did. That's what he did. And so, this is a Better You podcast with your host, Apostle Andre Ford. And one of the purposes is that we can move forward in Christ Jesus. That the words that I've shared with you, amen, what I've been pulling out from the Word of God, will encourage you to become that better you that resides inside of you. Amen. I can be reached at adfullwood@gmail.com. You can also give me a call, area code 630-706-1868. Amen. Twitter at Andre Fullwood, the number one. Amen. Just the one. Amen. Facebook, AD Fullwood. LinkedIn, you can look me up. Amen. And also on Spreaker.com. Amen. I pray, amen, that you have gained something out of this podcast today, that you are redeemed of the Lord. You can walk with your head up. You can walk with your chest poked out that my brother, Jesus Christ, redeemed me. Amen. From a life of hell and a life of damnation and from the wrath of God. Amen. Until next time, know that there's a better you living within.